ensure the welfare of your prehistoric animals and attract even more guests to your park, two additional enclosure types will be available to house the new avian and marine species, the aviary and lagoon enclosures. The aviaries offer modular construction, allowing you to craft dynamic enclosures, viewing galleries, and hatcheries, making these giant domes the perfect place to safely secure and view your flying reptiles. Lagoons are new, impressive, modular aquatic habitats. They can include a marine hatchery and a viewing gallery, which offers a spectacular experience for your guests during feeding time. These additional enclosures and animals will offer your parks new opportunities and new challenges.
Hello everybody and welcome to another Jurassic World Evolution 2 video, where today we've got another park management guide, this one regarding enclosures, specifically the Mosasaurus enclosure, or the marine reptile. We have a few more than just the Mosasaurus, Austin, you must realize this, and of course the aviary. And this park management just explains how each of them will work in your parks and how to manage them, basically. Well, not really manage them, it just shows more of what we know, which is what we were fearing when we heard about this, which, unfortunately, this does not give us too much. However, it does give us possibly a new species, which I think we should start with that first, which, in the aquatic zone, when we get a look at one of the marine reptiles coming out of the hatchery, it shows a fin coming out of the water. Now, a few days ago, there was a blurry image similar to this shown, and many people have begun talks about whether or not this could be a prehistoric shark, like Megalodon, which, I gotta say, is kind of strange, but seeing it up close, it's not entirely impossible, actually. Like, I do think it could be something else, like maybe a large ichthyosaur, because we know a small ichthyosaurus is already going to be in the game, and from the size of this, it looks nearly as big as the Mosasaurus, so it could be a larger ichthyosaur, we don't know. But the idea of it being a shark, which probably is going to be the title of the video, it's really cool. If we are getting sharks, it's going to be very weird, like, especially if it's Megalodon, because everybody's going to freak out about that, that's for sure. But I don't know how I feel about that if it was to be a shark. Like, I don't know, it just would feel kind of off-putting and stuff, but I still like it. But we don't get to know what the species is, which actually, because of that, that makes two aquatic reptiles that we still don't know what are. The one that we saw in the second dev diary that was nearly a month ago, good God, and this one. So we still have two unidentified aquatic reptiles now. This could be a shark or another ichthyosaur, we do not know. But going on from that, all we get to see really is how each will work, including like the aviaries and how you can expand them, which we've seen many a times before, and also how you can change the landscape inside of them, which is a feature that I personally really am glad to see. I wonder how far you'll be able to go. Like, will you be able to elevate or lower the land inside of it, or will it all have to be flat? That's something we haven't seen yet. Like, you've been able to place trees and rocks and all that stuff in, but can you elevate or lower it, and then will the pterosaurs act in a different way around it? I don't know. We could have something like that. That's just me. And we get to see multiple species interact with each other in the aviary, because in one brief shot, I can't remember where it is, but you're probably seeing it, we get to see a Pteranodon and a Dimorphodon beside each other, well, flying by each other, which, gotta say, glad to hear that. There was a bit of confirmation on that, like, months ago, but we haven't gotten to see it yet. But I wonder, will there be certain pterosaurs, like how with the aquatic reptiles, you can't have certain ones together? Will it be the same with the pteranodons? Like, say if we get Quetzalcoatlus soon, like when Dominion comes out, will it be like, oh, you can't have Pteranodon with that because Quetzalcoatlus could kill it and eat it? Will it be something like that, or will they all just be fine with each other instead? Who knows about that? And for the aviary, we get to see how it works and how viewing vents are and all that stuff. We just get to only see them fly around, unfortunately. And then for the aquatic lagoon, we get to see the viewing vents that were from the original Jurassic World film, and we get to see more scenery items, including a Spinosaurus skeleton, well, a skull. I want to see a full skeleton next. And this weird oval Jurassic Park door-shaped thing. I have no idea what that is. And also, that shark is really low to the water, I just realized. And other than that, we don't actually get too much, unfortunately, with this. Like, it's basically, once again, showing us what we already know, like how the aviary works, which we've already been told many times of, how the Mosasaurus, or aquatic, I kind of stopped saying Mosasaurus, it's just like I'm thinking only Mosasaurus. There's more than that, Austin. But yeah, unfortunately, like many are going to say, I would have preferred a species field guide, maybe on one of these unknown aquatic reptiles. Who knows, maybe we'll get that next week, because we've possibly only got two more aquatic species reptiles we probably only have two species field guides left until Jurassic World Evolution 2 comes out officially, which I cannot wait for. It's so close, guys. It's so close. But that is going to wrap up this video. Very short and stuff, but there isn't too much, unfortunately. But if you've enjoyed this video, I would appreciate the like, and if you haven't already, do hit the subscribe button to join the hunt. Be safe, and until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye.